So, Tim Miller, Jeff Rowe, saying basically, help us help you. Maybe that's what he was saying. Help me help you. What is the impact of last night in totality, do you think, of Donald Trump's performance, what Donald Trump said last night, in the last 3 weeks on down ballot races?
Yeah, I can't get inside Jeff's head. Good man, probably worried about down ballot races, though, because the reality is, before the debate even started last night, the campaign was over. Donald Trump does not have a mathematical path to 270 electoral votes. So what last night mattered was whether he could maintain any dignity left in defeat. He cannot, we learned, and whether he can keep this race close enough to allow us to maintain the House and the Senate. I think there's a lot of deep concerns about that.
No dignity left, Harlan.
You know, there's still 20-something days until the election. You know, when we went into Brexit in the UK, the Remain camp thought that they had it in the bag. They had a 10-point lead in the polls.
No.
And it turned out that
no.
they actually
The polls
didn't.
Were split. The polls were split.
No.
The
Look,
polls were
after,
split
after the assassination, no. After the assassination of the member of parliament, it was clear. So everybody that was commenting on it, I remember sitting on the sets of different TV shows, and everybody thought that it was a shoe-in for Remain.
The Brexit
and it
polls,
wasn't.
The betting markets, which is different than the polls, the betting markets thought that Brexit would lose, that Remain would win. However, the polls were split evenly going into the debate. It's just a fact.
Hey, you know, this is worth fact-checking because I remember looking at the aggregate of polls, and
it was
matter. Clear
it
that the Remain camp...
Who cares? Who cares what the Brexit
well,
was?
Donald it Trump's illustrates the point that the polling may not be accurate because it assumes different modeling that may not pan out.
Jeff Rowe actually looked. Jeff Rowe's a smart guy. Ted Cruz, they had great data. Jeff Rowe actually looks at the data. I look at the data. He knows that Donald Trump's in deep, deep trouble. And so that's what the reality
is. What Harlan's saying, I have heard very often, is they believe that one theory is the models are wrong in polling, and another theory is people aren't telling pollsters the answer that they are going to give when they walk into a polling booth.
Anytime Donald Trump or Donald Trump surrogates, things aren't going their way, they immediately go to conspiracy theories. The polls are rigged against us. The voting machines are rigged. The president's not really an American.
There is an element of boyhood pride.
We'll know in 3 weeks.
It's not rigging to suggest that perhaps the polling is inaccurate. We saw that there were points in the primary race where the polling was inaccurate.
But Harlan, you acknowledge that that Trump loves the polls when he's up, and he quotes the polls when he's up. He even sends around a CNN poll when he's up in it.
I totally
and then
understand.
Trashes it when he's down.
I totally understand your point. But and I don't think it's a conspiracy. I don't think that there is a concerted effort to manipulate the polls to suppress the vote for Donald Trump. If anything, I think him being behind in the polls actually works to his advantage, because I think that a lot of Hillary Clinton voters are going to look at the polls and say, oh, she's a shoo-in, and may not turn out on Election Day. There needs to be a sense of urgency for get out the vote. It's a double-edged sword for Hillary Clinton. She wants her voters to think that she still is in a competitive race.
Let's talk a little bit about some of the substance of what happened last night. You had Donald Trump talking about Vladimir Putin again. The issue of Vladimir Putin came up. The issue of Bashar al-Assad came up also in Syria. And Donald Trump doesn't really condemn them and their actions on the international stage. Is that something you would like to see him do more of, Harlan?
Well, look, no, he was. He was condemning or he has condemned Putin in the past. And I think it's important to say that we have been provided no evidence to substantiate the claim that Russia has participated in the hacks of the DNC and John Podesta's emails. Now, the federal government says, and Hillary Clinton last night said that 17 agencies said that this happened. I want to see the evidence, because as we saw with the invasion of Iraq, there have been multiple occasions in which the U.S. federal government has made claims about foreign powers that have not been substantiated, and it led to conflict.
Harlan,
and
okay.
I hear the war
Harlan
drums
can
beating.
Live in an alternative universe. Where I want to live is what Donald Trump actually said last night. What Donald Trump said last night was that Bashar al-Assad is smart and tough, and that we can work with Russia and Bashar al-Assad. And when pressed about the fact that his vice presidential candidate said that we would go after Assad, he corrected them in the second debate and said no. Bashar al-Assad is committing the worst genocide of the century. 500,000 are dead. We've done nothing. And Donald Trump says, I want to work with this guy. And then, when asked about dealing with our allies, like Germany and South Korea, he's like, yeah, they might be on their own. They should look at building up their own militaries. Hold on, Harlan. This is un-American. And when his campaign manager goes on this morning, when Harlan defends WikiLeaks, this is what happens in Russia. where your political opponents lose all right to privacy, you can invade their personal correspondence, you can embarrass them, you can jail them. That is not what we do in this country.
This is happening to Donald Trump as well. How about with his tax returns? Those were illegally leaked by the New York Times. It is the exact same thing. This is completely different than a foreign government looking at private
there individual
There is zero evidence that has been provided by the federal government to substantiate that claim. They have made the claim. I have seen zero evidence to substantiate that.
All of common sense brings evidence. Who else could be the Chinese? Julian Assange has been a Russian puppet. Julian Assange has been a Russian puppet for years now. The intelligence agency says
there are literally dozens of
actors. You can pretend it's not Russia. Even if it wasn't, then why does Donald Trump suck up to Vladimir Putin? Why does he say we can work with Putin and Assad, but I'm not going to help Germany and South Korea? Why does he say it's okay to go through the private emails of private people? This is un-American. The campaign they're running is un-American.
I'm frankly shocked by the fact that you're a Republican and you are defending Hillary Clinton
at
this point.
You were for Bernie Sanders two minutes ago. Don't lecture me on being a Republican.
Here's the thing. The reason Hillary Clinton is pointing to Putin is because she is trying to otherize him in this race. And this is her own way of planting the seeds of doubt in the event that she were to lose or that it's a competitive race, that she would contest the validity of the election. That's what this is
about.
You think this is Hillary Clinton trying to plant seeds
in order to contest the election?
Absolutely.
This is the first time I think there have been whispers about it
for quite some time. And frankly, people who are intelligence experts
know that it's the Russians. Harlan and all the other random Trump targets.
Will you guys stick around and talk a little bit more after break? We have a minute or two. If you guys will humor us, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
I wanted to know where my family came from. I did my ancestry DNA.
She has no idea whether it's Russia, China, or anybody else.
I am not quoting myself. I am quoting 17 intelligence. Do you doubt 17
military and civilian agencies?
Well,
yeah,
I doubt it. Vladimir Putin than the military and civilian intelligence professionals who are sworn to protect us.
All right, that exchange, mild in comparison to the one just before the break here between Tim Miller and Harlan Hill.
Let it continue.
It gets to the issue of, you know, do intelligence agencies suggest that the Russians are behind WikiLeaks? We have about a minute left, so 30 seconds each. Tim?
Look, I'm going to trust the intelligence agencies on this. Harlan can trust whoever he wants to. They say it's the Russians. And this morning on another network, Kellyanne Conway, Trump's campaign manager, was asked if it would bother her if it was the Russians that were hacking the Hillary campaign. And she said no, they would continue to do it. That is un-American. It goes against our constitutional principles. And the fact that Donald Trump is going to side with Putin and Assad over our military and go against constitutional rights is wrong, and it's disgusting.
Harlan?
The last time I was asked to trust intelligence blindly, we invaded Iraq. And that led to the loss of thousands of American lives and literally trillions of dollars. And so I'm not just going to blindly believe what I'm being told in an election year, especially.
I don't think that it's unreasonable
to ask for evidence to substantiate that claim, especially in the media. I think that we should be asking
but
for them.
But if it were the Russians, would you be okay with continuing to use this? If you knew it was the Russians that was hacking a political opponent to try to affect our elections, would you be okay with it still?
Because of the revelations that have come out.
That is not un-American.
A ridiculous allegation for you to make. That is insulting. That's insulting. And that just perfectly illustrates the degrading quality of our discourse in this country. You're going to call me un-American?
I respect the Constitution and privacy.
This discussion, though, has to come to an end.
Thanks,
advertising
guys.
Is American.